Hello friends, this is Dr. Hasim Khan, Associate Professor, Department of Psychology, Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh. Today I am speaking on Phi Coefficient. This is one of the statistical method from non-parametric statistical techniques. To define Phi coefficient is a measure of the degree of association between two binary variables. Binary means it has two categories. This measure is similar to the correlation coefficient in its interpretation, as we are having in case of Carl Pearson correlation coefficient. Similar to a parametric correlation coefficient, the possible values of a phi coefficient range from minus 1 to plus 1. Minus 1 correlation coefficient is as good as plus 1. It is perfect correlation. If we go for the binary variable, for example, gender is one of the variable. It has two categories, male and female. Marital status, two categories, single and married. If we intersect variables across 2x2 matrix, to estimate whether there is a non-random pattern across the four cells in the 2x2 matrix. Now moving ahead for the real-time case, a researcher wishes to determine if a significant relationship exists between the gender of the worker and if they experience pain while performing an electronic assembly task. So there were two questions before the subjects or workers. The first question was asked, do you experience pain while performing the assembly task? The response is yes, no. The second question was asked, what is your gender, male, female? Now, if you look into the different steps while solving the non-parametric statistical technique, the first step is to frame the hypothesis. In our case, the null hypothesis, there is no relationship between the gender of the worker and if they feel pain while performing the task. The alternate hypothesis, there is significant relationship between the gender of the worker and if they feel pain while performing the task. Step 2, the degrees of freedom for the phi coefficient is equal to 1 in our case, and the formula is same as we are having in case of chi-square coefficient. R minus 1 into C minus 1. Step 3, choose alpha level. In practice, we are going to use 0.05 level of significance and it can be interpreted as 5% chance of committing a type 1 error, or stated as 5% chance of rejecting the null hypothesis, when in reality it is false. Step 4, determine the critical value. As you know, in traditional method we use to go for the statistical tables to see the critical value of the test based on degrees of freedom. For the Phi coefficient, the critical value is determined using a chi-square table. The first column is the degree of freedom and other columns are the alpha levels. So at 0.05 level of significance with 1 degrees of freedom, the critical value is 3.84, as it is visible from this information. Step 5, run the test. To calculate Phi coefficient, the table should be prepared in such a way. It is a 2x2 matrix. Box A contains the number of males that said yes to the pain item. Box B contains the number of females that said yes to the pain item. Box C contains the number of males that said no to the pain item. Box D contains the number of females that said no to the pain item. So this is the table in which we are going to work to calculate the Phi coefficient. So if you see in the first column, the response for the pain items, yes or no, and gender, male and females. So these values are basically the counts, or you can say the frequency. The person who feels pain, there are 4 males and 6 females, and so on. Now this table is reproduced in such a fashion, all cells are designated by these A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. The formula for the Phi coefficient is BC minus AD divided by under root E, F, G, H. So these are the cells location in our table. After putting the value, we are having the value of the Phi coefficient is as 0.17. Now step 6, compare your score to the critical score. To interpret the 0.17 value of the Phi coefficient, you need to convert it to a chi-square value. The formula for the conversion is n into square of the Phi coefficient. In this case, we are having n is equal to 29 into 0.17 square is equal to 0.84. The decision criteria is that if the obtained score is greater than the critical value, reject the null hypothesis and accept the alternate. Since 0.84 is less than 3.84, we fail to reject the null hypothesis. Step 7, to make conclusion, there is no significant relationship between the genders of the workers and if they feel pain while they perform the task. Both males and females have pain or no pain at approximate equal frequencies. Interpretation: a rule of thumb, positive Phi coefficient would indicate a systematic pattern in which higher coded values on one variable are associated with higher coded values on the other variable, as in our case. Negative Phi coefficient would indicate a systematic pattern in which high coded values on one variable are associated with lower coded values on the other variable. Uses: the Phi coefficient is a measure of association between two binary variables, for example living, dead, black, white, success, failure. It is also called the ULIV Phi or mean square contingency coefficient and is used for contingency tables when at least one variable is a nominal variable. Thank you.